Hello and welcome to this webinar entitled Studying Respiratory Viruses with Air-Liquid Interface Cultures. In this webinar, we're going to go over different applications of the air-liquid interface system, in particular viruses. So there are many applications of the in vitro reconstituted human airway and air-liquid interface. This open culture allows for apical exposure, and you can apply many different things to the surface of these cells, including nanoparticles, gas, smoke, bacteria, viruses, and they can be used for a variety of different studies. We can look at host defense, viral bacterial infection studies, drug transport, toxicity testing, wound repair, look at gene therapy or gene expression, and cell biology and molecular signaling. These models can be used for preclinical drug development and disease modeling, and can be used for studies for COPD, cystic fibrosis, asthma, idiopathic pulmonary disease, lung cancer, and infectious diseases. If you're applying a virus to this culture system, there's a lot of information that you can get from these cells. From the top or apical part of the cells, and look at mucociliary clearance, cilia beat frequency, you can do ELISAs for apical cytokine analysis, TER measurements, or morphological evaluation. From the tissue itself, you can examine whether or not the virus has been internalized. If it's replicating, you can examine histological stains of these cells, look at ion channel activity, and different signaling pathways. And then from the basolateral side of the cells, you can examine cytokine release into the media or LDH release as an indication of cell death. These cultures are highly physiologically relevant and allow for antivirus drug screening and validation. Now I'm going to go over a few papers that have used ALI cultures in the investigation of different viruses. This is one study that looked at respiratory syncytial virus, G, and they have their cells growing nicely at air-liquid interface, where the asterisks here are the presence of goblet cells, and in here they stained the goblet cells yellow. And in part B and D, they're looking at cilia, so they've stained the cilia red. And their RSV is tagged with GFP. So you can inoculate these cultures with the virus and examine if it's being internalized and the spread of the virus over time. So it's well known that RSV selectively goes into ciliated cells. You can see with these two pictures, the GFP virus is inside the epithelial cells and it is in ciliated cells and not goblet cells. Other studies have used ALI culture for investigation of parvovirus. This is a study where they grew bronchial epithelial cells at air-liquid interface and they infected with the virus, the HBOV1. And through the TEM images, you can see that over several weeks of the virus infecting the cells, you see a loss of cilia and the cells are becoming a lot bigger, and this would be an indication of cell death, and they are investigating pyroptotic cell death by this virus as opposed to apoptosis or necrosis. And in this figure they show they've stained for the virus. This is a viral protein NS as well as beta tubulin, and there's a demonstration of a loss of the tubulin on the cell surface. And you can see that it doesn't colocalize with the presence of the virus, and therefore the cells that are infected are losing the presence of beta tubulin. ALI cultures have also been used for the study of rhinovirus. And in this first set of figures, they have examined the C15 rhinovirus, and they've stained the C15 capsid in the brown stain, so the virus readily infects the ciliated airway epithelial cells. And in the second set of figures, the group has stained for cilia and also for the virus in green. And you can see a loss of cilia in this combined image in the cells that have been infected with the rhinovirus. ALI cultures have also been used for coronavirus studies. And in this paper, the authors looked at the expression of the receptor TMPRSS2, TMPRSS2, which is the receptor for coronaviruses, one of the receptors. And they looked at the expression in different cell lines or in HBEs that are well differentiated or immature, and found that the mRNA expression of TMPRSS2 was much greater in HBEs that are highly differentiated. And this just demonstrates that these mature ALI cultures from primary epithelial cells express this protein and can be used for further coronavirus research. Likewise, we have shown that both small and large airway epithelial cells. So these are in pneumocal ALI media or pneumocal ALI S media for small airway. They also express ACE2, which is the other receptor for coronaviruses. So you can see in pink, you see a nice expression of ACE2 at the apical side of these epithelial cells. In red, we have the tight junction, and green is tubulin, representing the cilia. And ALI culture was used to first identify SARS-CoV-2, which is what is causing the COVID-19. So this was done by the China CDC, and they showed that in human airway epithelium, this is epithelial cells grown in air-liquid interface, that the virus actually causes some cell death. And then the TEM microscopy, they actually show the presence of the virus. This is a viral particle. And in the epithelial cells, they can observe the virus outside of the cells and that it has been internalized into these epithelial cells as well. So to summarize, air-liquid interface cultures of primary human airway epithelial cells provide a physiological model for the study of viruses. Key features are that it's an open 2D culture system that allows for directional infection with the viruses. These model systems can be used for regional specificity of the culture. For example, if you want to compare small versus large airway and determine niche of the viruses. And this is a mature culture system containing receptors for the viruses. And it is a model that contains goblet cells, ciliated cells that can be used to determine how the viruses will infect and spread in the airway. Thank you so much.